Well, hello, children. Oh, I'm so glad to be here. I've just stopped by to leave this record album with you. You see, for the first time in my life, I've invited someone to live with me at the North Pole, so we could record all the happenings with my friends while we prepare for Christmas. That's right. Now you can hear and see everything that happens at my home. It all started when I invited reporter Dick to come and live with me for about 20 days, right up to Christmas Eve. It was late one night when I called him, and he was kind of sleepy.
Hello?
Oh, is this reporter Dick?
Yes, but do you know what time it is?
Do I know what time it is? Huh, it's close to Christmas Eve and counting. Well, who better would know what time it is this season of the year?
Say, who is this anyway?
Ho, this is Santa Claus, reporter Dick. Santa Claus. And I haven't got time to talk about the time. I'm a busy man.
Santa Claus? But why are you calling me, Santa?
Well, I'm inviting you to spend the next couple of weeks with me at the North Pole. Now, you be ready, because I'm sending my very best sleigh for you, and be on the corner of Main Street.
Oh, boy, I knew I should have worn my long winter underwear. Wait a minute. What's that sound I hear? Why, I think it's Santa's sleigh. Hey, this is me, reporter Dick. Down here. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy.
You mean dear, oh, dear, oh, dear, don't you, reporter Dick? Come on now, into the sleigh with you. We've got a 6,000-mile trip ahead of us, and every minute counts this time of year.
I'm all set.
Okay, reporter Dick, now hold on tight. Okay, gang, away Dasher, away Prancer, away Dancer and Blitzen, away Dodder and Comet, away Cupid and Vixen, away, away, away tonight, over the rooftops and out of sight.
Santa Claus, 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 Santa Claus.
Here we are, reporter Dick. I told you we'd have you at the North Pole by the time you could say Santa Claus 100 times.
Wow, that was some trip. I'd only reached 95 Santa Clauses. There, that great big red and white house with the letters SC engraved on the door. Is that Santa's house?
You're absolutely right, reporter Dick. That's Santa's home and workshop, all combined into one. But come along now, it's getting late, and Santa's been waiting to welcome you.
Is that Santa singing?
It certainly is, and he's very proud of it. Next to making little boys and girls happy, Santa loves singing the best.
I'm getting awfully cold. Is it all right to knock on the door and interrupt Santa?
My goodness, yes. And if you don't, he'll go on singing until it's time to go to bed. Don't you tell a single soul. Oh, you'll have to knock louder than that, reporter Dick. It's hard for Santa to hear you over the sound of the elves at work.
At work? At this hour of the night?
Oh, yes. They'll be working around the clock from now until Christmas. But we'd better get you inside and in front of that fire. Here, let me knock on the door for you.
Well, well, well. Welcome, reporter Dick. Welcome to the North Pole and to Santa's workshop. Come in, come in. You must be nearly frozen.
Oh, thank you, Santa. I'll have to admit that fire is a mighty welcome sight.
Oh, I can see that you're getting ready for a good night's sleep, my friend.
I am, Santa. What time is it, by the way?
Well, here at the North Pole, it's very late as well as very early. But I'll explain that to you another day. Right now, a most comfortable feather bed awaits you upstairs. Come with me.
Oh, boy, does that bed look good, Santa. I'll just jump right in.
Wait, Dick, don't. Too late. I tried to warn you not to jump in. You have to roll onto it slowly, like floating on a wave. Here, let me help you out. There, that's better.
Oh, phew, that's the softest bed I've ever been in. Now, Santa, I think I'll just close my eyes.
Poor reporter Dick. He just can't believe that morning has come so soon as Santa tries to wake him.
Santa Claus,
wood that burns all year. Bottomless feather beds.
Oh, Reporter Dick! Reporter Dick! Come on, now. If you don't get up, you'll sleep the whole day through. Besides, I'm getting hungry and breakfast is almost ready.
All right, Santa, I'll be down as soon as I can roll out of my bed and get into my clothes. Boy, it sure is cold up here at the North Pole. Good morning, Santa.
Good morning, Reporter Dick. Oh, I certainly hope you slept well, and evidently you did.
Yes, I certainly did, Santa. Say, that looks good. What are we having for breakfast?
Well, to start with, here's a glass of fresh snow juice for you.
Snow juice?
Yes, new fallen Arctic snow, mixed with papaya juice from Hawaii. Delicious.
Delicious indeed.
And next, we'll have some special porridge made for me by my Eskimo friends to the south, covered with plenty of good reindeer milk. And then some juniper muffins and iceberg jam.
Reindeer milk? Iceberg jam?
Come, Reporter Dick, come on! Stop talking to yourself and get on with your breakfast. Why, in cold weather like we have here at the North Pole, it's important to start out the day in a full stomach. And when you're finished, I'll show you my home and workshop.
A little later.
What would you like to see first now, Reporter Dick?
Well, I'd like to see where the reindeer live. Tell me, where did you ever find Rudolph anyway?
That's an interesting story, Reporter Dick. It happened many years ago. You see, every now and then between Christmases, my reindeer and I take a little trip to plan the route we'll take Christmas Eve. Well, this one particular night, we were racing lickety-split across the sky when all of a sudden we found ourselves in the middle of the worst fog I had ever seen in all of my years.
Ho, ho! On Dasher! On Prancer! On Comet and Vixen! On... Whoa! Ho, ho, whoa, reindeer! Oh! Whoa!
Where did all this fog come from? Oh, I can barely see the end of my beard. Dasher! Dasher, how do things look up there? Can you make anything out through the fog?
No, Santa.
But what about you, Prancer?
My goodness, no, Santa.
Comet?
No, Santa, not a thing.
How about the rest of you?
No, Santa. The fog's too thick, Santa. I can't even see a single light.
Not a rooftop in sight, Santa.
Santa, I've never seen such a terrible fog.
Well, we'll have to fly out of this fog before we become lost. Prepare for a left turn. Away, Dasher! Away, Prancer! Away, Comet! Fog! I've never seen so much fog. Oh, can you see anything yet, Dasher?
No, Santa. Wait a minute down below, Santa. A red light. No, now it's gone. Now it's back. Gone. Back. It seems to be flashing, Santa.
Oh, we'd better have a closer look. Down, Dasher. Down, Dancer. Down, Comet and Vixen. Down, down. Well, Reporter Dick, when we landed, we found ourselves in the middle of a big forest. And that red light we had seen glowing through the fog turned out to be...
Was it?
Well, that's right, Reporter Dick. And we were mighty glad to see him. And as it turned out, Rudolph was glad to see us, too.
Well, I certainly can understand why you're so fond of Rudolph, Santa. Say, what's that strange sound, Santa?
Strange sound? What strange sound? Oh, I forgot that you haven't had a chance to meet all the members of my household yet. Oh, that strange sound, that's Snowbell, my favorite cat. And I've gotten so used to the way she sounds that I don't even notice it anymore. See, there's Snowbell over there.
That's Snowbell? That's a cat?
Well, sort of. Near as I can make out, she's a cross between an Arctic Angora, a South Sea Siamese, and an American alley cat.
And, what big, beautiful paws she has.
Yes, and very useful, too, Reporter Dick. You see, Snowbell loves to be outdoors every chance she gets, and her paws work like snowshoes and keep her from sinking into the snow.
Yes, I can certainly understand that, but tell me, Santa, why does Snowbell make that jingling sound when she walks? She isn't wearing any collar that I can see.
Well, Snowbell didn't always jingle like that. At least not before my reindeer and I took our annual vacation to the South Pole several years ago. Well, you see, that was where we found Snowbell. She must have become separated from her mother and father because we came across her huddled under some twigs and rocks trying to keep warm. And the poor thing was nearly starved. Well, as we were fixing a bowl of reindeer milk for her, Vixen sneezed. And it was such a big sneeze that one of the bells on Vixen's collar flew off and landed right in front of Snowbell. She must have thought it was something to eat because, well, by the time I could bend over to pick up the bell, that lovable old cat had swallowed it in a single gulp. And so, ever since, she's been jingling wherever she goes.
Look, Santa. Snowbell's pawing at the front door. Does that mean she wants to go out?
It does indeed.
Aw, may I come too, Santa? I'd like to get a little fresh air myself.
Well, all right. But you'd better wrap yourself up in that reindeer blanket over there so you don't freeze.
Anything you say, Santa. You sure were right, Santa. It is cold out here. And the wind must be blowing 50 miles an hour.
Oh, just keep that blanket wrapped around you and stay close to me.
Who is that stranger, Santa? You there, stranger. I asked who you are.
I'm...
That's all right, Reporter Dick. Don't be frightened. That's only Mr. Winter. Now, Mr. Winter, don't go getting yourself all riled up. This is my friend, Reporter Dick, and he's come to visit with me until Christmas Eve.
He may be your friend, but that doesn't make him mine.
But Mr. Winter, I...
Now, Reporter Dick, he's not really as mean and terrible as he sounds. What he needs is for you to get tough right back. Now, stand up to him.
You're sure, Santa?
Sure as we're standing here at the North Pole.
Well, all right. Listen, Mr. Winter, you don't scare me one little bit. You're nothing but a big bag of wind.
Is that so? I'll show you.
No, Mr. Winter, I was only kidding you.
Wait! Mr. Winter! Now look what you've done, Mr. Winter. You've knocked my friend right over into a big snowdrift. Here, Reporter Dick, let me help you up.
Thank you, Santa.
Come on, Reporter Dick. We better get back inside and give Mr. Winter a chance to warm down. I'll not soon forget this, Mr. Winter. And I've got a good mind to talk to Mother Nature about you. Get inside.
Oh, that was a close call. Does Mr. Winter often lose his temper like that, Santa?
Well, don't get upset now, Reporter Dick. I'll tell you what. I'll fix some hot chocolate, and you just sit there and relax. And then maybe I'll sing the song that you like so much. In fact, I'll sing it now for you. Oh, this is a song about me. Jolly old St. Nicholas. Well, would you children mind if I sang along with you? We have to sing three verses now. Talk about Susie and Johnny, all of them. Okay, I'll sing with you. Jolly old St. Nicholas, lean your ear this way. Don't you tell a single soul what I'm going to say. Christmas Eve is coming soon. Now, you dear old man, whisper what you'll bring to me. Tell me if you can. When the clock is striking 12, when I'm fast asleep, down the chimney broad and black, with your pack you'll creep. All the stockings you will find hanging in a row, mine will be the shortest one, you'll be sure to know. Johnny wants a pair of skates. Susie wants a dolly. Nellie wants a storybook. She thinks dolls are folly. As for me, my little brain isn't very bright. Choose for me, old Santa Claus, what you think is right.
Now, you just make yourself comfortable right over there in Santa's chair by the fire, and I'll have Mrs. Claus make us some hot chocolate, reported Dick.
I don't want to take your chair, Santa. I'll just pull that bench up in front of the fire.
No, reported Dick. You're my guest, and Santa's chair is your chair.
In that case, I guess I will stretch out by the fire. I'm still a bit tired from my trip to the North Pole. Say, this certainly is a comfortable chair, Santa. Where did you get such a wonderful chair?
Well, it was made for me a long, long time ago by my elves. And it's carved out of one of the most beautiful of all trees, the giant redwood that grows in California and lives to be thousands of years old. And that, reported Dick, is why I'm so very, very proud of it. Now, I'll go see about that hot chocolate.
I haven't met Mrs. Claus yet. May I come with you, Santa?
Well, all right. But first, I better explain how difficult things are this time of the year for Mrs. Claus. You see, she's in charge of all the baking. Christmas cookies, pies and cakes, plum puddings. My, oh my, she doesn't have a spare minute left for anything else.
I understand, Santa, and I promise not to interrupt her.
Well, very well, reported Dick. Come on along, but be as quiet as you possibly can. Any loud noises could make a whole oven full of cakes fall.
I promise, Santa.
All right. Now here we are, reported Dick. Now remember, very, very quiet.
Yes, Santa. Santa, this is the most delicious-smelling kitchen I've ever been in my entire life.
Now you know the secret of why Santa's so fat and jolly.
There must be a million cookies on these tables. I can certainly understand why Mrs. Claus doesn't have time for anything else at Christmas. She seems to be everywhere at once. I don't believe she's even noticed we're here.
No, she hasn't. You see, she's trained herself not to let anything break her power of concentration. Now I'll just get all the ingredients she'll need for our hot chocolate and put them right here on the stove for her. If you'll be good enough to reach that container. No, no, not that one. That's the pepper.
Watch out, sir. It's spilling.
Oh, my goodness. I'm afraid I'm going to sneeze.
Me too.
Oh, shoot. There go the cakes. We're in trouble now.
A short time later...
Well, at long last, here's that hot chocolate I promised you, Reporter Dick.
Thank you, Santa. I hope Mrs. Claus isn't terribly upset with this. It was all my fault.
No, no, goodness no, not at all. We even had a good chuckle about it after you left. The only thing is, you're going to have to help me eat all those cakes she had baking in the oven.
Tell me, is there a particular Christmas you remember more than any other?
A particular Christmas, huh? No, I don't... Wait a minute. There was that Christmas Eve when, for one terrible moment, I was afraid I wouldn't be able to pay a visit to a single boy or girl.
What happened, Santa?
It seems my reindeer and the elves decided to play a prank on me. And so they made 8 mechanical deer who could do nothing but just stand there and shake their heads at me. I'll tell you, reported Dick, it gave Santa the scare of his life. Now, my friend, it looks as though you're ready for a good night's sleep.
Oh, I think you're right, Santa. That hot chocolate made me mighty sleepy.
You sleep well. And remember, you must roll onto that feather bed.
I'll remember, Santa. Easy now. Roll under the bed gently.
Good night, Reporter Dick. Sleep well.
Thank you, Santa. The same to you and Mrs. Claus.
Good night, Dick.
Huh?
Good night, Dick.
What in the world? Who's there?
Good night, Dick.
Either I'm hearing things or there's someone there. I'll just light this candle in my dresser and have a look around. Now we'll see what we shall see. there's no one under the bed.
Good night, Dick.
Who are you? Where are you?
Up here, Dick. Up here in the bedpost.
Huh? Well, I'll be. It's a mouse. Sitting straight up and smiling at me. Santa? Santa, can you come up here a minute? I want to show you something you won't believe.
Oh, all right, here I am, Reporter Dick. What do you want to show me?
There. There, Santa, sitting on my bedpost.
Hi, Santa.
Oh, hello there, Tidbit. Did you frighten our friend, Reporter Dick?
No, Santa. I only wished him a good night.
You two know each other?
Oh, yes. You see, I found Tidbit in one of my empty sacks after returning to the North Pole one Christmas. He crawled in during one of my stops at a farmhouse. And when I took him out of the bag, he was holding a small tidbit of corn in his paws. And so we named him Tidbit. He's been our mascot ever since.
Well, nice to meet you, Tidbit.
Nice to meet you too, Reporter Dick.
Oh, all right now, back to bed with both of you. I've got to get back to work.
Yes, Santa. I'll just hop right back in bed.
Wait, Reporter Dick. You forgot to roll under the bed.
Here. Oh, Dick, here, let me help you up again.
Oh, thank you, Santa. I promise to remember next time. Good night, Santa.
All right. Good night, Reporter Dick.
There we are. Oh, yes. Good night, Tidbit.
Good night, Dick.
As morning arrives, Reporter Dick's dreams of Santa Claus Land are shattered all of a sudden by a strange sound.
What in the world is that?
Good morning, Dick.
Good morning, Tidbit. Oh, what was that noise I heard?
Noise? That was no noise, Dick. That was me, playing my bugle. Listen.
Yes, Tidbit, I can hear that. But why are you playing your bugle this hour of the morning?
I was picked to be the Christmas Eve morning bugler this year.
A Christmas Eve morning bugler?
Yes, you see, it's very important that everyone be up very early on the morning of Christmas Eve to help Santa get ready for his long journey. So, every year, one of us gets to wake the others up by blowing the bugle, like this.
Yes, I understand, Tidbit, but you don't want to become overpracticed.
You're right, Dick. Besides, Santa's waiting downstairs to show you his workshop.
Minutes later...
Well, Reporter Dick. You're looking all rested and ready to go this morning.
I am indeed, Santa, and looking forward to seeing your workshop.
Well, come along then, Reporter Dick. But you'll have to be quiet as Tidbit the Mouse, so we don't disturb the elves at their work. They have very little time left until Christmas Eve. Here we are. Santa's workshop is right behind this big red and white candy-striped door.
My goodness, Santa, I see what you mean. They really are hard at work. But why are the elves dressed in three different colored uniforms?
That's because every elf has a special job to do on each toy they make. The elves over there, dressed in white, have the task of creating the toys and teaching the elves who are dressed in green how to make all of the different parts. And then the red uniformed elves assemble the parts, pack the finished toys in the boxes, and wrap them in Christmas paper.
I see.
The most important thing to them is to get all the toys finished, so all little boys and girls everywhere will have a merry, merry Christmas.
What's behind this big door here, Santa?
Yeah, that's where the toys that need to be repaired are stored until the elves have time to fix them.
Oh, I'm very good at repairing things, Santa. Maybe I can help.
Oh, wait, Reporter Dick. That closet's piled up to the top with toys. Oh, too late again.
Boy, oh boy, Santa and Dick have had a busy day, haven't they? But after a wonderful dinner from Mrs. Claus, We hear them talking as they sit and relax by the fire.
That was a delicious dinner, Santa.
I'm glad you enjoyed it, Reporter Dick. It makes Mrs. Claus very happy when we eat everything on our plates. Well, now, suppose we just relax for the rest of the evening. In fact, if you'd like to, we could join the reindeer and sing Christmas carols with them.
Oh, I'd like that very much, Santa.
Well, come along now. Come along. We'll sing as we go, okay?
Deck the halls with boughs of holly. Fa la 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 la.
Well, children, while Reporter Dick and I are walking to hear the reindeer sing, let's you and I have a song to sing. What about this one? Jingle Bells. Sure you know it. We all know it. All right, now, I'll sing one chorus with you, and then I'm going to let you sing all by yourself. And you can do it. Okay, now, let's go. Here we go. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Ho, ho! Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Ho, ho! Very good, children. Now it's your turn. As we're dashing through the snow here on this course, pretty soon jingle bells will come up again, and then you do it all by yourself, okay? And then we'll get back to my home. See what happens with the reindeer and many other surprises. Here you go. Oh, ho, ho. Very good, children. Very good. Now let's get back. Here we are, Reporter Dick. Let's go in.
Very nice. Very nice.
I wish I could sing along.
Oh, I didn't see you standing there. No, don't be sad. Reporter Dick has promised to try to teach you to carry a tune before he leaves.
You love to sing, don't you?
Oh, yes.
Well, then that's the most important thing. You love to sing, not how well you sing. Join in, and remember, just enjoy yourself and sing along.
All right, Reporter Dick, I will.
Later, in front of the fire...
Well, Santa, I certainly did enjoy our sing-along with the reindeer. With a little practice, we could probably get on television.
Oh, I did too, Reporter Dick. And I think you did a splendid job.
Santa, there's something I've been wondering about. When I arrived at the North Pole, I asked you what time it was. And you said it was very late as well as very early. What did you mean by that?
Oh, that's an easy question, Reporter Dick. You see, the tip of the North Pole, where Santa's home and workshop is located, is the exact point where the longitude and latitude timelines meet. Therefore, the time here is the same as it is everywhere else in the world. And so, it can be very late or very early, depending on where you happen to be from.
Yes, of course, I remember that now from my study of geography. But I guess I never thought I'd be standing, sitting at the North Pole.
Well, well. I wonder who that could be at this time of night. Oh, when I get comfortable.
You just sit there and rest, Santa. I'll see who's at the door. Oh, my goodness! Santa!
Yes, yes, Reporter Dick. I'm coming. What's the matter? Who was that at the door?
That was Mr. Winter.
Well, now, he's not here to hurt us.
But
let's
but,
just find but, out what he wants. Well, well, Mr. Winter, welcome. What can we do for you?
I just came to apologize for being so huffy with your friend, Reporter Dick, and to return Snowbell to you. Old Snowbell must have gotten caught outside when I scared you. And, well, I'm sorry for the way I behaved.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Winter. It was very nice of you to pay us a visit.
Yes, it certainly was, Mr. Winter. And I'm very sorry I called you a big bag of wind.
Well, Yes, well, oh, good night, Santa. Good night, Reporter Dick.
Good night, Mr. Winter. Come along, Reporter Dick. Let's get Snowbell into the living room so she can warm up.
There now, Snowbell. I'll just set you down here by the fire, and you'll be all warm and cozy in no time. Well, now, Reporter Dick, it's growing late, and you're probably...
Look, Santa. Hi, Frosty.
Old Frosty's up later than usual. He must have something special in mind. Well, let's see what he wants, Reporter Dick. Good evening, Frosty.
Hi, Frosty.
What can we do for you, Frosty? Oh, well, I don't know, Frosty. It's awfully late, but I'll ask him. Reporter Dick, Frosty wants to know if you'd like to go sledding with him tonight.
Sledding? My goodness, I haven't been on a sled for, a good many years. But, yes, I'd like that very much.
Well, good. You get into that reindeer blanket so you won't get cold, Reporter Dick. Now, you two have a good time, and I'll see you in a little while.
Thank you, Santa. Goodbye. I'm right behind you, Frosty. Lead the way.
A little later...
We must be going faster than a jet, Frosty. I can't see a thing in all this snow. I hope you know where we're going, Frosty. Wow, we've stopped. We must be at the bottom of the hill, Frosty. Oh, it's snowing so hard now, Frosty, I can't even see you. Frosty! Frosty? Are we lost?
Hours later.
Oh, there you are, Frosty. Oh, am I ever glad to see you. Frosty, who's that with you? Oh, my goodness, it's... Quick, Frosty, run for your life. There's a giant bear behind you. Run, Frosty, run.
Oh, hold on there, Reporter Dick. I won't hurt you. I'm here to help you. Right, Frosty?
Who are you?
I'm Polly the Polar Bear, Reporter Dick.
I'm pleased to meet you, Polly.
Pleased to meet you too, Reporter Dick. You see, I went ice fishing this afternoon, and when I stopped to give Santa some nice fresh fish a little while ago, he told me he was worried about you and Frosty. So... I set out to look for you, and here I am.
Oh, boy, and not a minute too soon, Polly. I'm nearly frozen. Are you all right, Frosty?
Frosty's just fine. He loves this kind of weather. But even old Frosty can become lost when it snows this hard. Come along now. Each of you hold on to one of my paws, and I'll have you back at Santa's before you know it.
And that's the story, Santa. I'm certainly glad that Polly decided to pay you a visit tonight.
I should say so, Reporter Dick. I should say so. Well, now, why don't you just finish that hot chocolate Mrs. Claus made for you, and then run along to bed? I suspect we'll have a busy day in store for us tomorrow. Yes, well, you're getting ready for bed, Reporter Dick. I'm going to sing a song that all the children will love to hear, especially on Christmas Eve.
Well, it's been a long time since Up on the Housetop, too. How about singing this one? Remember now, Up on the Housetop, click, click, click. Ho, ho, ho. Okay, now.
Get ready to go. All right. Here we go. Up on the housetop, reindeer's paws. Out jumps good old Santa Claus. Down through the chimney with lots of toys. And all for the little ones' Christmas joys. Ho, ho, ho. Who wouldn't go? Ho, ho, ho. Who wouldn't go? Up on the housetop, click, click, click. Down through the chimney with good Saint Nick. First comes a stocking of little Nell. Oh, dear Santa, fill it well. Give her a dolly that laughs and cries. One that will open and shut her eyes. Ho, 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 who would know? Ho, 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 who would know? Ho, up on the housetop, click, click, click. Down through the chimney with good Saint Nick. Ho, 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 that was very good. Very, very good, children. Now let's see. There's one more verse. Would you like to do that? All right, now it starts out. Say, next comes a stocking of little Will. Okay, you ready? Here we go. Next comes a stocking of little Will. Oh, just see what a glorious fill. Here is a hammer and lots of tacks. Also a ball and a whip that cracks. Ho, 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 who would know? Ho, 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 who would go? Up on the housetop, click, click, click. Down through the chimney with good Saint Nick. Ho, ho, beautiful children. Oh, that was so nice. So very nice.
Dawn is now breaking clear and cold over Santa's home and workshop, where Reporter Dick is sleeping soundly in his big feather bed.
Tidbit. Oh, it sure is cold this morning.
I know. Santa asked me to tell you that Mrs. Claus had a nice hot breakfast cooking on the stove.
Oh, good, good, Tidbit.
What's the matter, Dick?
Why, I can't seem to find my shoes, Tidbit. What was that?
Oh, my. Slippery is up to his old tricks again. You bad elf, Slippery. You give Reporter Dick back his shoes this very minute.
Elf? Slippery's an elf?
Yes, and a very naughty one at times. When it gets close to Christmas, Slippery gets so excited, he plays pranks on us every chance he gets. Santa? Santa?
Yes. Yes, Tidbit. What's the trouble?
Slippery is up to his old tricks again.
Oh, come here, Tidbit.
We've looked everywhere for Dick's shoes and can't find them, Santa.
All right, Slippery. You've had your little fun. Now, tell us where Reporter Dick's shoes are. What's that?
Look, at the window. It's Mr. Winter.
And he's holding my shoes. I'll open the window.
Santa, someone left these shoes hanging outside your window. And it didn't look quite right to me. Not quite right. And so I decided to bring it to your attention.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Winter. Those are my shoes.
Very strange, these reporters. Very strange. Oh, well.
Very strange, that Slippery. Very strange. Yes, but don't worry, Reporter Dick. Slippery loves you just like he loves every one of us here at the North Pole. You see, it's not that Slippery is a bad elf, Reporter Dick. He just gets so excited about Christmas that he bubbles over with energy. And some of that energy gets turned into mischief.
Good morning, Santa. Good morning, Reporter Dick.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, Reporter Dick.
Well, I... What a beautiful package. For me?
Yes, yes. Yes, Reporter Dick. Open it up.
But it isn't Christmas yet, Santa.
I know, but this is something you'll need for your trip home. And Christmas Eve is drawing near. Open it, open it.
Why, Santa, it's a beautiful red stocking cap. Just like the one you wear. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome, Reporter Dick. And I must say, it looks very good on you.
I'd like to give you something in return, Santa. I've been thinking about it, but I haven't been able to think of anything. Tell me, Santa, what would you like for Christmas?
Oh, Reporter Dick, children all over the world ask Santa what he wants for Christmas. And I'm going to tell you the exact same thing that I tell them. It's something that doesn't cost a lot, but means more than anything in the whole world. What does Santa want for Christmas? I'll tell you what I would like for Christmas. Someday, tomorrow, the next day, maybe this Christmas, every year, when you see your mommy or your daddy, your brothers or your sisters or your relatives, or your friends or your playmates next door, children, just walk up to them and say to them, I love you. I love you very much. Children, this is the nicest thing that you can give Santa Claus for Christmas. It's the nicest thing that you can give to anyone for Christmas. Anyone at all. And they'd be so happy to have it. And remember that I love you too, my dear children. Very, very much. So you see, Reporter Dick, that's all Santa Claus wants for Christmas. Is for you and me and everybody throughout the world to love each other. What nicer gift could you give to anyone?
Well, Santa, with such a long journey ahead of you tomorrow, I imagine you'll want to get a good night's sleep.
Oh, my, no, Reporter Dick. Not tonight. Tonight I have to recheck my list to make certain I haven't forgotten any little boys or girls before I turn it over to the reindeer in the morning. There'll be plenty of time for a good night's sleep or two when I return.
I can hear Tidbit upstairs practicing for his Christmas Eve morning bugle call. He certainly takes his special assignment seriously.
Yes, Tidbit's a good little mouse. And I plan to reward him for his enthusiasm. You see, each year Tidbit asks if he can go with me on Christmas Eve. And this year, I plan to let him come along with us.
What was that?
Oh, I'm not sure, Reporter Dick. That sounded like Tidbit calling for help. Come on, Reporter Dick. Oh, here we are, Tidbit. Tidbit, where are you?
His voice seems to be coming from the bed, Santa.
Oh, my goodness. He must have fallen into the feather bed. Help me find him, Reporter Dick. Help me. Let's get these covers off the bed.
We'll find you, Tidbit.
Not here. No, see, not over here either. There, I found him, Reporter Dick, right here.
Oh, my. I thought I'd smother in that bed.
What happened, Tidbit?
It's that slippery. I was just practicing for tomorrow's Christmas Eve morning bugle call when all of a sudden Slippery pushed me off the bedpost and into the bed. Slippery, you bad elf.
Now, that's all right, Tidbit. Slippery, mind you, you better be good from here on out.
That's telling him, Santa.
All right, Tidbit, you just put away your bugle until morning, because it's getting late, and it's time for you and Reporter Dick to be going to bed.
Yes, Santa.
Yes, Santa. Oh, it does feel good to stretch out in this wonderful bed. I'm going to miss this bed, and Santa and all the other friends I've made up here at the North Pole. I can't believe that Christmas is almost here. But it is. I can hear it in the air.
Thank you.
Reporter Dick sleeps well after another day full of surprises at Santa's. But his next surprise comes earlier than he expected.
Sugar plums. What?
No, it's Tidbit.
Everybody up! Everybody up! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Tidbit?
Get out of the hay, because today's the day. Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Everybody up! Everybody up! Merry Christmas!
Tidbit, why are you carrying on like that?
It's Christmas Eve morning, Dick. Christmas Eve morning. And I'm the Christmas Eve morning bugler.
What do you mean, Christmas Eve morning?
Lots to do. Lots to do, Reporter Dick. You get dressed, and I'll go check on the others. Charge! Hurry now, you elves. Keep those packages and presents moving to the sleigh. Hurry now. Keep the line moving.
Well, good morning, Santa. Merry Christmas.
Oh, good morning. Good morning, and Merry Christmas to you, Reporter Dick. Sorry, but I won't be able to join you for breakfast. I have a lot of things to check on before we go. Enjoy your bowl of porridge. I mean, your bowl of porridge.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Reporter Dick. Sorry, but I can't stop to talk right now. I have to run through Santa's list with the other reindeer. We don't want to forget any of the little boys or girls, you know. Bye.
My goodness, things certainly are busy around here this morning. Good morning, Snowbell. Goodbye, Snowbell. I guess I'll just walk on down to Santa's workshop and see if I can be of any help to the elves. Here we are. Seem to be confused enough without me offering to help them.
Hello, Dick.
What? Oh, hello, Tidbit. Would you like to play a game of checkers with me?
I have to go find Santa and ask him if I can go with him tonight.
Aww.
Just look at all this activity, Dick. And to think I started it all with my Christmas Eve morning bugle call. Charge!
All right, everyone. Come on now, it's getting late. We have to be leaving in a minute or two. Are all the presents wrapped and packed? Oh, good, good.
Uh-oh. I left the beautiful red stocking cap that Santa gave me upstairs. I'll just run up and get it.
All right, everyone. It's time to go now. I sure hope I haven't forgotten anything. Are you all ready, my hearty reindeer?
Yes, Santa. All ready.
Good. And what about you, Tidbit? Are you all warm and comfortable there in my pocket?
Yes, Santa.
Good. Then I guess we're all set to go. Goodbye, elves. Thank you for all your hard work. Oh, you'll make the children very, very happy come Christmas morning. Goodbye, Snowbell. Take good care of Mrs. Claus. Goodbye, Mr. Winter. Don't be too hard on us this trip.
I'll try to be good, Santa.
Goodbye, Frosty. Goodbye, Polly. Have a Merry Christmas.
And a Merry Christmas to you, too, Santa.
Goodbye, all. Away, Dasher. Away, Dancer. Away, Prancer, Comet, and Vixen. Away, Donder.
I'm glad Reporter Dick is staying on with us, Santa.
What did you say, Tidbit? I couldn't hear you in all this wind.
I said, I'm glad Reporter Dick is staying on with us, Santa.
Staying on? What do you mean, Tidbit? We're taking him to his own home for Christmas.
Then why is he back there on the ground, waving to us, Santa?
Oh, what? What?
Santa! Come back!
Well, I'll be. I forgot Reporter Dick. To the rear, Dasher! To the rear, Dancer! To the rear, Prancer! Comet and Vixen! There, Reporter Dick. That looks like your house down there.
It is, Santa. It is.
Well, well, your family will be mighty glad to see you again. Down, Dasher! Down, Dancer! Down, Prancer! Comet and Vixen! Down, Donner!
Reporter Dick. Right at your front door.
Thank you, Santa. I don't know how to tell you how much I've enjoyed my visit with you, and...
I understand, Reporter Dick. I understand. We enjoyed having you, too. Goodbye, Reporter Dick. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Santa. Goodbye, my reindeer friends.
On Dasher. On Dancer. On Prancer. Comet and Vixen. On Donder. Cupid and Blitzen. On into the skies. On. The children soon will be opening their eyes. Ho, 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 ho.
I wonder if it all really happened. It already seemed so long ago. Yes. Yes, Santa. Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Well, Dasher, it's about time we got ready to go. Santa has to go, children. Got many things to do. A lot of things to pack and get ready for Christmas.
Don't go, Santa.
Oh, sweetheart, darling, Santa has to go. There's so many things to do for Christmas.
We'll come back.
Why, of course Santa will come back. After all, what about Christmas Eve? Remember, the night before Christmas? Well, that's when Santa will be there. Santa has to get started right now and pack things.
Santa Claus.
Oh, yes, darling, what can Santa do for you?
I love you, Santa.
You love Santa? Santa loves you too, darling. Let's see, I think I've got everything. My boots. Where's Dasher? Dasher! Dasher, get up on that sleigh. All right, here we go. Bye-bye!